to Paulo. He's going to tell us about the Shovelier.
So the question is, what is a shelevator? So let's move on. It's a big oyster growing platform. This is the Shelevator Ranger 5000 fully loaded. It has Darcy trays on it. And this is our smaller model. We started out with one that has 12,000, but it's absolutely scalable. So let's move on. So it's an uplifting apparatus. And what it does is pneumatically, we bring in compressed air through those green lines. And there's an exhaust port at the opposite end of those tubes, which forces out the water, much like a hydrolift boat. And this thing pops up out of the water. It's in 7 foot of water right now. So it's uplifting, and it's out of sight. This is my lovely wife, Diane. She's towing this thing with a kayak. A powerboat, you could probably hook up a dozen of these and move hundreds of thousands of oysters out of sight. And that might be a good thing to do if a hurricane's coming or a freshwater event that killed all my oysters in July. But you might want to move them to get better growth conditions, higher salinity for flavor, avoid a oil spill, a harmful algal bloom, to move before an event to an area that's not going to be closed when it rains 4 inches or the river stage goes up. So out of sight has another side to it. So you spell out of sight. Now this is not a shelevator. These are some gear in New York that floats, and the white stuff up on these, you might guess what's caused that. When you have any kind of floating gear, you're going to invite the birds over there, and they're going to do their business there, and that's not something they're having to close down these areas because of the fecal-coliform counts. But the other thing about out of sight is that the residents on the shoreline don't see those sticking out of the water, and the thieves don't either. So it's a added layer of security. So why is the show? Why would you want a shelevator? Well, the original reason was to labor reduction, for desiccation, for density reduction or harvest. You just turn on a valve there and it pops up in under a minute. So it reduces your risk either from human health or from oyster health. So you can move it out of the way. Which also reduces your uncertainty. You know that you can move this to an open area when your area gets ready to close. And it's got a three-dimensional footprint. This one had 6 layers of oysters, so if you have a small area, you can fit more of these up, and like on next to up here or something like that. The other size expands your capacity. You've gone tenfold bigger, so if you got your hurricane, all you gotta do is open your valves to sink them. So if you had 1,000 pieces of gear, now you got 100 pieces of gear. And at a bandwidth, a lot of your gear you need to wade in, unless you have really calm conditions, you can get in a boat. The current shelevator goes out to 7 foot, but we have a new model with floats on top that would operate in any depth of water. So you're including your bandwidth to pretty much all coastal waters in Alabama. Now, you got the capability of moving it for growth, flavor, to purify. You can move oysters into the Gulf and get rid of Vibrio vulnificus to non-detectable levels, or you could take them away from, say, a polluted area.
Paul, we switched around a lot, and you guys can ask Andy a couple questions while we switch over to the next speaker.
What's the FDA say about moving oysters? Yeah, there's folks in California have a federal permit and everything. I've applied for a grant, and one of the it's a Gulf Coast Marine Fisheries, and one of the things is to start aquaculture in the Gulf of Mexico. So we're going to take baby steps first. I'm going to move them to Soup's Farm over there in an area that's already got a permit, and then we'd like to take an area and buy a labatchery in Grand Bay and move it out past the closure when it, you know, rains 4 inches or there's a sewage bypass, so that you could continue to operate and have a cash flow. And then, I'd like to be able to have other non-riparian rights so I could move for flavor. But a lot of permits, yeah. But But you don't get anywhere unless you put in the first application to do that.
All right. There's a question back there.
So, Andy, fully loaded and grow up, how many boards would you pull in?
That's the Shell Invader 5000. So that's 5,000 oysters. Yeah, but you could get, the tubes I have right now are 12 inches in diameter and 20 feet long. I'm experimenting with some lighter weight pipes and everything, and that would move it up to 72 inches.
Thank you, Andy.
Thank
appreciate
you.
It.